In this video, I'll explain all the letters and numbers they put on our lenses. And once you understand all these letters and numbers, it's easier for you to select your next lens, and it's also easier for you to take better pictures. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto. I'm a photographer and a Lumix ambassador from Helsinki, Finland. And in this video, I'm going to take a look at all these letters and numbers that they put on our lenses, and I'm gonna translate them to you. And while some of these words and numbers are not significant in real-life photography, but there are some numbers and letters that are essential, and I think it's very important to know what they mean. I'm gonna start with this number here. And it's the focal length of the lens in millimeters. And that is the most important number on any lens because it defines the lens, what kind of lens it is. Whether it's a so-called wide-angle lens or a standard lens like this one here, or maybe a telephoto lens. The focal length tells us the angle of view of the lens. It tells us how much of the scene we can capture from any given distance with that particular lens. If it's a wide-angle lens, we can capture like a wide view, a lot of the scene that is in front of us. But if it's a telephoto lens, we can capture only a narrow angle of view and a small portion of the scene in front of us. But let me first explain what the focal length means. Let's assume we have a camera lens that only has one lens element inside of it. The focal length of that lens would be the distance from that lens element to the sensor in millimeters when that lens is focused at infinity. So if the focal length of the lens would be 25 millimeters, then the distance from the lens element to the sensor would be 25 millimeters when the lens is focused at infinity. However, in real life, camera lenses very seldom have only one lens element. They usually have 3-4 lens elements, or maybe even more than 20 lens elements. So the distance from the lens to the sensor is not that easy to measure. However, that one lens example gives you a pretty good idea what the focal length means. And like I said, the focal length is usually in millimeters. On their Micro Four Thirds lenses, Panasonic doesn't use any letters after the number, but on their full frame lenses, they use the letters MM after the focal length to tell you that it's millimeters. MM stands for millimeters, of course. This lens has only one focal length written on it, and this lens is called a prime lens because of that. This has a fixed focal length, only one, 25 millimeters in this case. But this other lens has two numbers written on it because this is a zoom lens. There are numbers 12 and 60, and the 12 millimeters is the focal length at the wide end of the zoom range, and the 60 millimeters is the focal length at the long or narrow end of the zoom range. And the smaller the number, the wider the angle of view, and the higher the number, the narrower the angle of view. And if the lens's focal length is approximately the same as the diagonal dimension of the sensor, then that lens is called a standard lens. And any lens that has shorter focal length than that is called a wide-angle lens, and any lens that has a longer focal length than that is called a telephoto lens. And for example, in Micro Four Thirds, the standard lens is roughly 25 millimeter lens like this one here. And in full frame, the standard lens would be roughly a 50 millimeter lens, give or take a few millimeters. So I just told you that the focal length of the lens somehow equals to the angle of view of the lens. And it kind of does, but it's not, unfortunately, it's not quite that simple. And that may sound a bit confusing now, but let me show you a picture that I shot on my Lumix S1R full frame camera, and I used a lens that had a focal length of 25 millimeters, and the picture is here. And now if I used this same lens on a Micro Four Thirds camera, the picture would look like this. And as you can see, there's a lot less in the picture, a lot less of the scene. And that's because the sensor area is smaller and it's only able to capture that smaller portion of the scene. So that 25 millimeter lens is actually a wide angle lens on a full frame camera, but it's a standard lens on a Micro Four Thirds camera. And if there are two 25 millimeter lenses, the same focal length, but the other lens is designed for a full frame camera and the other lens is designed for a Micro Four Thirds camera. The lens design on both of those lenses would be fundamentally different, even though the focal length is the same. The lens designed for a full frame camera would have to cover much bigger sensor area than the lens designed for a Micro Four Thirds camera, even if the focal length of those lenses is the same. For a full frame camera, the lens design would be a wide angle lens, and for a Micro Four Thirds camera, the lens design would be a standard lens. But let's move on to the second most important number on any lens, and it's this number here, right before the focal length. It's something like 1 to 1.4 or 1 to 2 or 1 to 2.8 or something like that. And that number essentially tells us the maximum diameter of the aperture inside of the lens through which the light travels into the camera. And the smaller the number, the larger the diameter of the aperture, and of course, more light can travel through a larger aperture than a small aperture. And it may sound a bit weird that the smaller number translates to larger diameter, but that's because this is a relative number. And the number is also called the f-number or the f-stop, maximum f-stop or maximum f-number of the lens. And I'll put a link down below so you can dig deeper into this if you're interested to find out more about the F number or F stop. And because it's a relative number, every lens that has the same F stop or F number lets through exactly the same amount of light, regardless of the focal length. And like I said, the number on the lens tells us the maximum diameter of the aperture, or the f-stop. But you can, of course, always set a smaller diameter aperture or f-stop using your camera's controls. And usually the smallest the diameter aperture is something like 16 or f16 or 22. And this is the same 25 millimeter prime lens I showed you before, and this only has one maximum F number written on it. Because it's a prime lens, it can only have one maximum F number. But this zoom lens here, this has two maximum F numbers. There is 3.5 and 5.6, and the 3.5 is the maximum aperture number or f-stop at the wide end of the zoom range at 12 millimeters. And the 5.6 is the maximum aperture number or the largest aperture at the telephoto or narrow end of the zoom range at 60 millimeters. Many zoom lenses have a variable maximum aperture like this one, but some lenses also have a constant maximum f-stop. And on such zoom lenses, there is of course only one maximum f-stop written on them. But there's something else I have to say, or otherwise I'll get a lot of comments on this. I just told you that the maximum aperture number or f-stop number on the lens tells you how much light goes through the lens. But that's not entirely true, because the f-stop, the number we see on the lens, is just a mathematical number and or a theoretical number. And the light transmission of any lens is never 100%. So there's also something called a T number that is being used on dedicated cinema lenses. But I'm not going to talk more about that, because in photography it doesn't really matter. But I'll put a link down below if you'd like to find more about the T-stops and F-stops and the differences between those two. And then there are some other letters and numbers written on the lens usually, but those numbers and letters are not nearly as important as the focal length and the maximum aperture. However, there are a couple of numbers that are good to know, and that is the filter size, which is usually somewhere on the front of the lens, and then there's the minimum focusing distance, usually written somewhere on the side of the lens. And the minimum focusing distance is always measured from the sensor to the subject. So the minimum focusing distance from the front element to the subject is always shorter than the minimum focusing distance on the lens. So the most important numbers on any lens are the focal length and the maximum aperture number. And those you have to know and understand. And by the way, here are a couple of other videos that you might find helpful after watching this one. Thank you so much, and I'll see you again in the next one.